procedures that are done on pump mean that the heart is rendered still during the operation. The patient's own heart is not supporting life. The heart and lung functions are taken over by a machine. That renders the heart completely quiet and easy to sew to. In beating heart surgery or off-pump surgery, the heart has to continue to work even as you're sewing the bypass grafts on it. And that can be difficult because maneuvering the heart into position, twisting it so you can get to these vessels that may be on the back wall of the heart, compromise its ability to function and pump blood to support life. And so it can be difficult to do beating heart surgery, in some circumstances. But if it's just one vessel on the front of the heart where the heart doesn't have to be twisted around and it can continue to beat normally, it's really just as good as doing it on pump.
I think if you go back about 15 years ago, I think that as the equipment was older, I think the equipment's gotten newer. I think the techniques have gotten faster. So limiting your time on the heart-lung machine is very important as well. And I think if you can have a good team that works well together and it's very efficient, I think that it's got the on-pump has actually really approached the outcomes of off-pump.
Yeah, exactly. Now, 20 years ago, there was a lot of enthusiasm for off-pump surgery, and it was going to be the next big thing in heart surgery, and everyone was attempting to do it. But what happened was it turned out not to be as easy as people thought, and the heart-lung machines got better, and surgeon skills got better, and we're on the heart-lung machine for such a brief amount of time today that it really doesn't affect the patient adversely much at all. So really, it's the benefits of it, having a still, quiet, non-beating heart to sew these precise, and these vessels, remember, are a millimeter in diameter. I mean, they are very, very, maybe 12 sutures in a 1 millimeter diameter vessel.
Right, these sutures are really the size of your hair.
Are smaller.
So right.
So having a very stable platform and a non-moving surface, it makes a big difference. And there are other issues as well. There's some blood clotting issues as well, and enter some hematologic issues. But the big thing is the beating versus non-beating heart.
Well, I think it depends upon the patient themselves too. So it depends on where the blockages in the arteries are. For instance, if they have multiple blocks, sometimes it's going to be difficult to stay off pump because it's a lot better to go on pump, which Dr. Purut was saying that you have a lot more stable field where you can put precise stitching in. I think initially when we were starting to do off-pump surgery, it was about 20 years ago now.
20 years.
What happened was I found when I was doing it, if I did one vessel off-pump, not using the heart-lung machine, it was actually faster.
Mm-hmm.
But once you hit three, four vessels, to stay off-pump actually took longer in the procedure itself because you actually had to, because every time you do a bypass, you have to reposition the heart with a stabilizing device to stay off-pump. When you're on-pump, you could just move the heart around. So I found, I think if you were doing two bypasses, it was about the same time. But I think once you start approaching three, four bypasses, mm-hmm. it actually took longer to stay off-pump.